Exactly.
So I'm pretty sure we're going to Dreamland. Yes, correct? Yes, sir, maybe?
Yes, it is.
All right, so Dreamland, first game. Marlowe versus Nightmare.
All right.
Diddy versus Sheik. Let's see how this game's going to turn out, guys. Recon 2015.
Oh, game trip.
It's a jab combo, no DI out, able to get the finish.
All right, you got the hoo-ha? Well, the
hoo-ha! Oh, good mid-air catch off that banana.
All right. Good combos grab, but gets punished by the hoo-ha. Meh.
Tripped up on the platform of the banana, but it's fine.
Oh, could have went for a follow-up, but then...
Yeah, that roll was pretty projected. He could have followed up with that. Starting off pretty slow. These players trying to fill each other out. Jab combo, able to get the finish, knock him off stage, but Sheik able to make it back with a bouncing fish.
Alright, so banana to down smash, not bad. Alright, try to go for a ledge jump, but then fail to. Oh.
Oh, with the grab off that off smash on the shield, facing the wrong way, unfortunately. No punish on that upbeat. That might cost him, though. And it does. He gets punished with an up smash to get the first stock.
Alright,
good forward air combo. Get rack up some more percent. And I'm sure that's one problem with Sheik, though, is her kill power. It's not it's hard to get the kill on Sheik.
Yeah, you need to find a way to get through that. We'll see. But right now, I think the best thing Brian can do right now is either a down throw to up air, or probably a gim. Or a bouncing fish.
Tries to read his DI with that bouncing fish.
Alright, the hoo-ha. Ooh. Nice side B.
Alright, good roll to get back into center stage. Dash attack by Marlowe. Not able to follow up much.
Oh, but gets
took all the needles to the face. Good.
Alright, bouncing fish? No follow up. Oh, down charge, down smash.
Try to get the ledge from there, misses it.
Alright, nice nair. Get him off stage. There you go.
Alright, good
nice
follow-up.
Nice fish. Gimp, oh!
Out of the way from the bottom of Dreamland.
Alright. So, Marlowe's back on stage. I wonder what he's gonna do next. Alright. Never mind. Hoo-ha? No.
Ooh,
just delayed.
Yes.
There you go. Oh, trying to go for a stage spike, but...
Trying to time his invincibility, but...
Oh yeah, something I didn't mention. Your invincibility frames from the ledge decrease as your percentage rises.
Oh, interesting. I did not know that fact about Smash 4. That's actually a pretty good mechanic. I like that.
So if you can probably study how many frames or how many seconds of invincibility they have left...
Well, that's grab and throws him back to throw off stage. Wall jumps, I don't think that was intended.
Probably missing him.
Good up tilt. Not able to kill though because it's Dreamland, one of the bigger stages.
Right, so Marlowe has center stage right now. Brian needs to find a way in. Oh wait,
good. That was a good setup by Marlowe, able to get that banana throw into the up smash. Catches his approach. We got a replay. Oh, we esports now, boys. All right, amazing. Good replay, bro. I appreciate it.
So, will we be seeing a switch? Brian's thinking about it.
Do you agree with switching right away? Like, even if it's a best out of five, or do you think you should just stick with what you started with? Try and see if you could change something.
If it's something that you think it's not gonna work out, I believe you should switch. But then, if you think you can, if you think you did something wrong, and can make it up for it, then just stay that person.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Yeah.
Okay, so I think we have a character switch. It's Sonic now.
Sonic. Yeah.
Now we have a huge speed advantage.
You gotta go fast.
All right. So we're going to FD. Alright. Starting off the game.
Catches him without that forward air.
Oh!
And that actually, like, is a... In a competitive play, it's actually a reasonable thing to do because you get into your opponent's head, trying to make them tilt so they play, like, even worse.
Yeah, true. It may not work sometimes if someone has a strong mentality, but...
Yeah, but if they're already breaking and added on, then it gets pretty hard to keep your mental strength.
Yeah. Alright, so Marlo is slowly taking it back. Slowly. He's making some good progress, but then... Alright.
It seems like Marlo's really trying to go for the reads because he's not able to keep up with Sonic's speed.
Alright, so... Oh, there we go. Sonic doesn't have much space anymore. It's in. Oh, there. He's on stage.
Oh, bad approach with that up air. He gets punished with his Diddy Zone up air.
Bad there by Brian. Gets punished really easily.
I'm surprised Marlo is going out there for these offstage edge guards when he previously got gimped for doing that. So it shows his confidence that he's not really fazed by it. He's still confident going offstage and not getting gimped.
He just wants his style for the hype. All right.
Forward air. All right, just get that percent. Get him off stage.
All right. Okay, Diddy's back on center stage. I'm pretty sure Sonic can get him off soon. There, right now.
He tries to read him, but I guess punished for that up smash with the grab. Now he's off stage. Could be a. I like the attitude though. Both players are Marlo just laps it off, shakes it off. Now he has to think about the next game because game three is one of the most important games when it's a best out of five, especially when you're both 1-1.
Yeah.
It really changes the momentum and how it feels because you get the huge counter pick advantage. You think he's gonna switch here or he's gonna stay with it? From what I saw, it seems like he kind of has to switch.
Maybe did he? Or hey, no. Alright, I can't see anything. Probably Falcon. He's looking. No.
So he's gonna stick with his guns. He's confident. Maybe that was just a flub. Maybe the stage. Another stage will work out better for him. Let's see what adjustments he makes in the third game. See if he can get the momentum back on his side.
If he can possibly take his neutral game and not go for any spikes or any offstage.
Offstages.
Yeah. Then he should be able to take out Sonic pretty easily. Alright, we're going to Castle Siege. I believe that's legal. Whatever. Alright, for here, I'm not sure about the blast zones here.
Plus, is this the stage that also transforms, correct?
Yes, it transforms. Yes. And then there's like walk-offs. So, it could be anyone's game if they're
in the wrong spot at the wrong time.
Yeah.
Alright. Oh, good down smash to punish that no-tech.
And then Ryan comes back with a fair. Ooh, back here. Didn't go for any tech chase. Aw, didn't catch him.
Ooh, four smash it out. Just trump his approach. Charging his neutral view right at the edge. Pretty dangerous thing to do. So here we got a first transformation.
Alright, so here's the walk-ups. They have to be super careful and not get backdoed or anything.
A different kind of gimp.
Yeah.
So again, yes, Nightmare doing the right thing, trying to get back into center stage, get away from those blast zones, right away from any of the cheese.
Yes. Okay, good. Good on Brian's part to get out of that walk-off. Ooh, Marlo tries to go trip him and backdrill him, but no. Brian says no.
So both of these players just not willing to approach, don't want to make any too bad of mistakes and get punished for it.
Yeah.
Both these players playing really safe, spacing each other out, playing the neutral.
I think the smartest thing to do is just wait for the next transformation.
This is like Melee's Pokemon Stadium. Now it's like an FD mode, basically.
Yeah. Alright,
can this be a gimp? No. Nope. Oh. Able to get back to the edge.
Alright, so for this stage, the stage kind of wonks left and right.
Yeah, just tilts around.
Yeah. Could probably mess up someone's recovery. Oh no, didn't get the banana.
Gets caught with the back air there. Not too bad. Able to get the edge.
Oh,
ooh,
nice.
Ooh, a good banana dub smash, but a high ceiling, able to save him.
Oh, he tried to go first. Oh.
Ooh, good attempt on those stage spikes. Pretty risky, but able to recover back.
Alright, so he's off stage right now. Oh, transformation again. We'll see what happens. Because right here...
Go back to the neutral.
Alright. Because if they were in the... During the transformation, if they were like in the very left or very right, it could have been...
It could have been like under the stage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, back throw? There you go. Oh,
It seemed like he could have DI'd that better.
Yeah. If it doesn't have the red mark, then... Or sometimes the flash isn't really... It doesn't indicate when you're really dead.
And that back throw, and it kills him. So back to step one. Both of you guys are at low percent. Only 3 minutes left, halfway through the match. These players really decided to slow the game down.
Yeah.
Trying to play it more neutral, trying to pick their spots better.
Okay.
Oh, unfortunately gets caught. I don't think he was expecting to get caught by that side B there.
Alright. Brian has to play super safe right now and not get gint.
So it looks like Model was trying to cheese him here, forcing him to approach. Maybe trying to get a grab to a back throw. But it gets ran. Sonic speed, it gets pretty unpredictable.
Alright. He has to be very careful. With this percentage, 48%, he could possibly get killed.
So anytime Nightmare gets tossed off toward the side of the stage, he immediately goes high to try and get back onto that top platform, make it back to center stage, which is a smart thing to do.
Yes.
Yeah, both these players are really being patient right now. They do not want to lose this third game.
Yeah, if they have a 2-1 advantage, then they have all the time in the world to think of what they can do. Also, if it has a 2-1 event, if they have a 2-1 advantage, they probably won't have.
All right, good grab, Lee 2. An up air. Oh, tries to read his air dodge, but Nightmare not going for it. Able to air dodge at the correct time when Marlo threw out his up air.
Okay.
A good air dodge again for the recovery. Gets hit by his up B though. It's not percent you want. But now he's off stage. We get a gimp, possibly. Tries to go for the stage spike. Misses it slightly. Here we go. This could be the last stage transformation. Well, these players are really tense right now. They do not want to make that last mistake, but it gets covered. 2-1. That really hurts Nightmare. Let's see if he's going to change characters here or stick with it. Maybe change up the stage.
He's in a lot of pressure right now, so he really needs to think.
You do not want to get sent to the loser bracket.
Marl has an advantage, but he has to be very he has to be careful as well. He cannot be careless at this point. He needs to end the game maybe about now. Wait, a change to Luigi?
So Luigi pick.
Alright. Okay, so Luigi has been significantly been nerfed, but Brian can work it out.
What specifically though?
His down B cannot kill anymore.
Yeah, those were set up like down throw to up air or down B.
Down throw to up B. Down throw to up. No.
Down throw down B, right? Like
yeah,
the tornado.
Down B.
Yeah.
And his aerials have less knockback. Some of his aerials. Okay, so we're in Town City.
And both these players just really trying to space out.
Good hoo-ha.
Good back air. Yes.
Nice dash attack.
Has him off stage, but a new Now, this is the last stock for the winner's bracket. Let's see if he can make it back, but it's not looking so good right now. It doesn't look like his character pick is working out for him. Platforms are now gone. So now it's basically we're on FD mode. Could this be another gimp? No. Able to get back onto the ledge. Another back there, getting him off stage. So now we have winner's final, Marcelo versus Marlo, and our loser side is Takai versus Nightmare.
Yes.
Unfortunate game 4 there. Marlo